On behalf of the Office of International and Alumni Relations at IIT Madras, I want to welcome everyone to this function to confer the award of Distinguished Alumnus on Professor Pittenan Kuppuswamy for the year 2015. These awards are usually given on Institute Day, which is this year it's going to be on April 17th. But Professor Kuppuswamy happened to be in India when the announcement was made, and he was telling us that it may be difficult for him to come back again in April. So we are very happy that he was able to find time from his schedule to stop by the campus today and pick up his award. We have out of 42,000 plus alumni, we have given the Distinguished Alumnus Award to only about 120. So you can see that it's a very, very select group. And every year we have a very large number of outstanding nominations to choose from, and the selection committee finds it extremely difficult to make the choice. And so this year we are giving awards to 10 of our distinguished alumni, which is the same number that we gave last year as well. And we're very pleased to have Dr. Kuppuswamy here with us today. And with that, I will invite the head of the chemistry department, Professor Bharadraju, to read his citation.
Good afternoon. Dr. Pittenan Kuppuswamy obtained his PhD in chemistry from IIT Madras in 1985 and earlier completed his BS in chemistry from Government Arts College, Namakkal in 1975 and MS in general chemistry at the Pachaipas College, Chennai in 1977. He is currently professor of radiology and associate director at the EPR Center for the Study of Viable Systems in the Geisel School of Medicine, Dartmouth College. Prior to this, he was professor in the Department of Internal Medicine and adjunct professor in the Department of Biomedical Engineering at Ohio State University, Columbus. He also served as director of the Center for Biomedical EPR Spectroscopy and Imaging at Ohio State University from 2002 to 2013. Postdoctorate, Dr. Kuppuswamy was Fogarty Fellow 1986-87 at the National Institute on Aging, NIH, Baltimore, MD, and also served as Research Fellow 1987-90 at John Hopkins University School of Medicine, Baltimore, MD. During this period, he worked with two renowned biophysicists, Dr. J.M. Rifkind and Dr. J.L. Zweier, thereby beginning the journey from chemistry to physics to biology. Dr. Kuppuswamy was a pioneer in connecting the technologies of imaging and EPR, electron paramagnetic resonance, spectroscopy, giving rise to the EPR imaging field, which still has only a few expert practitioners worldwide. His positions of responsibility in fields as diverse as heart and lung care, cardiovascular medicine, and spectroscopy reflect the interdisciplinary nature of his work. Dr. Kuppuswamy considers it his mission to create new knowledge and to disseminate it to a large number of intelligent young men and women. The large number of students he has mentored bear testimony to this. His 300 plus publications over 30 years in high impact factor journals and the 7 patents are indicative of the quality of his technical vitality. Dr. Kuppuswamy has, more than anything else, created centers of excellence to produce quality manpower and research. Noteworthy among his many awards are Doctor of Medicine Honoris Causa, conferred by the University of Pécs, Hungary, Silver Medal for Biology Medicine, awarded by the International EPR Society, and the Lumley Award for Excellence in Interdisciplinary Research, awarded by the Ohio State University College of Engineering in 2011. To highlight another facet of Dr. Kuppuswamy's contributions, his development and production of multilingual Tamil, English, French, and Malay multimedia software for learning Tamil language and literature has enabled the Tamil diaspora to stay connected to their roots. His contribution to the digital Tamil revolution has been recognized by a Doctor of Letters Award conferred in June 2012 by the International Tamil University. In recognition of Dr. Pittenan Kuppuswamy's pioneering contributions to the field of EPR imaging and his commitment to mentoring of young minds, IIT Madras and its alumni are proud to confer on him this award.
Now invite the director to confer the award. I now invite Dr. Kupuswamy to say a few words.
Distinguished Director, Dr. Bhaskar Ramamurthy, Professor Nagarajan of the Dean of the International and Alumni Services, Head of the Chemistry Department, Dr. Varadaraju, and other deans, faculty, and friends. I'm very grateful and touched to have been selected to receive this honor from my alma mater, IIT Madras. I'm also very proud among the most accomplished alumni IIT that have been received this award in the past years, and I'm very grateful and thankful to you for having me receive this award. I have received many awards, as Professor read out, but however, I consider this as the most important one, touching personally, because this is not from my institute where I work or some other university for recognition of something, but this is something from where I started it all, my alma mater. I remember, or you may remember, through Valluvar's the couplet, Indra Polidin Periduvakum Tanmaganai Chandron Yanaketa Thai. Alma mater literally means the mother who nourished you, and I feel like coming home to receive this honor from my mother, you know, after 30 years of my graduating from this place, and that's why I said this is a very important one for me of all the awards I have received. Just to give you my time, my perspective at that time, I was here at IIT Madras, that was 35 years ago. The first thing that impressed me was, of course impressed everybody, was the environment. The moment you go through the city, enter through the gate, you enter into a new world, you know, it's entirely different. It was like that, it is like that still, it's even better now, more, the trees have grown much bigger now. The environment, just the nature and the animals, and also the departments at that time. I graduated from a government college first, and then Pachayappa's College, Chennai, and then I worked there as a lecturer for a couple of years. And then when I came here, it was amazing place. I visited here before, actually I'll come to tell you about that later, that I wanted to do PhD here, not anywhere else. So that's one thing, the environment also, the faculty, teachers, the resources available, the best resources that you can find in India were here at that time for research. Since I was doing on magnetic resonance related thing, you need all the instruments to be, you know, available, that's one thing. And so that's the environment that was great. The second thing that was great was the kind of teaching and mentorship mostly. You know, PhD requires not much teaching, but requires mentorship. You need someone to guide you, direct you to do what you want to do. In my case, I was fortunate to have PT Professor Manoharan, and he is not just a mentor. Some time ago, they asked in the interview, can you say something about the mentor? So it's already recorded. So the thing it was different was, he is not someone who will tell you what to do. He is someone who will train you or how to do it. That's what, he won't tell you what to do, but he will tell you how to do it. He won't tell you, you should work on this problem, this field, yourself, you know, things like that. He never did that. He will kind of leave us free, and then ask us to come, okay, what do you think you want to do? This is it, okay, then I need this facility. And then he will make sure that I know about it. I have all the resources available. Even if not, he will connect us to the other laboratories in the country or even outside the country. He will get the measurements done. That's how great was my mentor, which influenced me a lot. When I go out, I became a mentor myself. That's the thing. Don't tell them what to do, but tell them how to do it. I think that's important thing in research. The training is important, not exactly the product that comes out of the training. Because using the training, you can always even change the field and do something else. It is the training that's important. That's what I got from IIT, and then I have been applying this for 30 years after that, and I have been very successful in that, received awards as a mentor, distinguished mentor award and all that. So that was another one about IIT, if I recall. And then the next third one is the recognition. In the US, I'm in the research, I've been in the research all the time, doing magnetic resonance, EPR research all the time. Every time you fill out a form, write a grant proposal, this and that, you have to say where, I think people recognize you, not from your undergrad degree or this or even some other honorary degree, but recognize you by the PhD degree that where you got, the institution. And the moment they read or the moment they hear that I came from IIT, and that's enough. Everybody knows IIT. They don't have to Google to find out where this college, that college, where Kuppuswamy graduated. But that name recognition, that also helped me and all the alumni a lot, because which is very important. Even if you apply for, I didn't have to apply for a job. I applied first time and then after that I kept moving on. But people that apply for a job, even for the first time, the IIT, those three letters make a big recognition of your degree, whether it is a PhD or BTech or MTech, whatever it is. So those are the three things that I remember that I gained, and I have been kind of thinking IIT, keeping IIT as my alma mater forever, and that's why I said it. So my mother is not here. She passed away just 2 or 3 months before I graduated from here. And so now it's very fitting to say that So I thank you for that. Then in conclusion, I would like to thank all the teachers that taught me what science and other things in life, and all the great mentors. Piti Manoharan is one of them. That also I had Subbu at that time here at RSIC, and I was enormously benefited by the group and the sophistication of the instrumentation and the environment. And always my mentors pushed me above a step beyond of what I thought I could reach, always. That's how I came up in life. I can't come from a very place. I didn't have any mentors in my own family. People direct me what to do next, etc. So it's all by my teachers before and my mentors after. And so thank them and also my colleagues who were here as well as now back in the US and research that work with me, because it's not research. When I do this 300 publications, it's not just I did the work. You need good collaboration, good scientists, good relationship with the people, my colleagues, and again my friends, and most importantly, you know, not the least, is my family, which my wife is here, Lakshmi is here, and I also, she was not graduate or anything. It's happened that 10 years ago I trained her to do biomedical research, and now she is a scientist. She has nearly 20 manuscripts published, and that's kind of, I'm telling, proud of myself as a mentor. If you can mentor your wife, which is the most difficult thing, okay? To make someone, so your spouse, listen to you not at work is the most difficult. This is the living proof about my ability. So together, we work at home. You know, research is not a 9-to-5 job. Research is a 24-hour job. There are no holidays. And so I also thank her for that. And in conclusion, with gratitude, I'm very delighted to accept the award from IIT. Thank you very much.
On behalf of the Institute, I want to start by saying that the Institute, the chemistry department, of course, but the Institute in general is very, very proud of your achievements. And while we would have loved to give you this award on Institute Day when there will be a big function, we are also happy that you are the first from this cohort of PAs to get the award. So, boni pandrathu epome.
Yeah, I forgot to thank you for that. Again, so, also I'm the first.
So I think on that count, I think you score. So, one of the interesting things we find when we award a very limited number of these Distinguished Alumnus Awards, and I can tell you, it's done by a very thorough process involving a lot of mostly people from who are some alumni and others from outside. But I observe the process, and there are always at least an equal number who ought to be getting it. It's so tight. But what's interesting is the diversity of the awardees, the kind of work they do. It's very often the work has diversified quite a bit from what they did for their PhD or for their master's and so on. And so we're very happy to see our alumni doing all kinds of things. You know, and that has been exemplified in your case also. You know, your move from chemistry to all the way now in medicine. And the fact that you've committed yourself to creating knowledge and training a whole lot of people, mentoring, doing what you saw was the high point of in your evolution, and giving it back 100 times to others. This is really what it's all about, and we are very proud of what you've done. And we hope that this will catalyze a new phase where you will remain, you will develop a stronger relationship with the institute. Come and go. We have work going on here. Now the institute is much larger. The research footprint is very large, much larger than in your time. Today we take in 500 PhD students a year, whereas when you joined, it was probably 60 or 70, 80, 100, or in all. The research footprint is very large, and there are faculty and there are students working on all kinds of things. So we look forward to distinguished alumni such as yourself to, whenever you get the opportunity, to engage with us, engage with our faculty, engage with our students, help us overcome bigger challenge. So thank you very much, and I congratulate you and your family and everybody. We are particularly happy when we see our alumni who have come from modest beginnings in small town India, all the way, even more satisfying. So you are one of those in that category, so we are very, very doubly proud.
Yeah, actually, I didn't tell that story. If you have a minute, I finished my master's. People advised me that I should go to United States to do my PhD. Even a member by name Kamala, Professor Nithiraj College, filled applications for me. I got admission also in the United States, but I didn't want to go. I wanted a job first. Being come from a family, a job was more important than a PhD. I joined the college, and Professor Shanmuganathan, S.P. Shanmuganathan, was the principal of my college, and he was also my head of the department. And he said, okay, why don't you do PhD with me, part-time PhD. I joined for about a year. And then he came and gave a lecture at IIT, at Pachepas College. And I went and asked him, all right, I changed my mind. I want to do PhD with Manavagar. And he was very happy. He said, I will let you go. I will let you leave only if you join PT Manavagar. And if you only work in theoretical chemistry, ESR, and with that, he let me go. Unfortunately, at that time, IIT had advertised for the FIP program, Faculty Improvement Program. So I used that. So I had my job. I came here on that program, finished my PhD, went back about 6 months or so. I stayed there. So I came here to do PhD with him, but he was not here. At that time, in the chemistry department, the regulation was you rotate around 3 months or so, and then say, choose your mentor, they will assign. I chose him, but he was not here, and there was some issue. How can you select someone who is not, he was on sabbatical in Netherlands. And so I had some problem, and Subbu came to my rescue saying that, okay, we can make it happen. So that's how I became, joined him. And then he came back, spent a year, again went out for 2 more years, I believe. That kind of a significant portion of his absence in the laboratory, in addition to that help, not that he didn't do anything, he was always communicative and write, those days no emails, you know, call or write, and he was taking care of everything. But the plus, something else came out was the survival issue, how to do things without somebody directing me on a daily basis, things like that, gave me that kind of doing things on my own. And it was all a great thing, turned out to be great. I think at that time, if I remember, I think I was the most published graduate when I left the institute, 14 publications, something like that. It all worked very well. Anyway, he was my mentor, teacher, and again, we have been collaborating. I went there, he comes to my lab, visits sometimes, summertime, and we published together. The most recent publication was a couple of years ago. And also he invites me here every couple of years. Whenever I come here, he invites me to chemistry department to give a lecture. I gave a lecture last time I came here. So I have been in touch with the institute, and I'll also continue to do so.
Professor Ramamurthy, Kopraswamy, colleagues, Mrs. Kopraswamy. Well, it was, I don't know, whatever he has said are correct. I don't want to echo it back again. But I would like to say this, that is, when I was, one day I was, I got a telephone call from Professor Shanmugamanathan. Even he may not remember. Shanmugamanathan told me, I'm going to send a fellow to work with you. I told him it would be my pleasure. And he said, you asked him to come and talk to me. And of course, his representative was another student of mine. I mean, our, he's right now, he's in Stanford. So he came and talked to me. If I remember, I talked to him on the telephone, and I was very happy. But that's a starting point. In between, I went for a short time. At that time, short time to the US. At that time, he seemed to have decided to come here, and everything worked well for him. But it is true, Kopraswamy is one guy, you know, who can take care of himself, provided you tell him how to do it rather than what to do it, as he said. So initially all my PhD scholars have a run on course, which is that the course giving system is part of any American university. In Indian universities, they do not so much insist on it, but I do. So I used to give special courses, which is not even in the what is called listed courses in the chemistry department. I normally teach, you would be surprised to see, normally teach about three courses. One is, of course, the BTEC course. That's compulsory, I do that, along with my large number of colleagues. Second thing is, I teach a postgraduate course, which I make it myself compulsory. But then there is an obligatory note on it that I will give also a course purely for PhD scholars who are interested in whatever I could teach. Sometimes it's on mass spec spectroscopy, sometimes electron spin resonance spectroscopy, sometimes on crystal field theory, and whatever it is, quantum mechanics and what advanced quantum mechanics. But with all these things, there are a few people who could actually be shaped very nicely, provided we give them what we want. And this is something I actually learned from my own PhD guy, Professor Harry Gray. He never asked me, what are you doing? You only asked me, what did you do? What are you doing is different. But he said, what did you do? Any news? PT, you'll come and slap on me. I said, did you have any news for me? If I don't have any news, that's all right, go ahead. Come tomorrow. That's all. And afterwards, I joined as a research assistant professor at Michigan State University, which was even worse. I have to choose my own problem. All the instruments were there, that's not a problem, but I'm also a theoretician, so I could combine them together, could do well. Probably I thought this is probably the right method of doing, rather than just pumping them as, did you do this, did you do that, etc. Nothing like that. That's my style of doing research. Some people resent it. In fact, some people could not react with it. They find it very difficult in this case. But they have to be fed. But that I reserve it for the last 2 years, not in the first two or three. Most students of mine work anywhere between 4 to 5 years to get the PhD program. This is very similar to what happens in most American universities. Somebody used to say, how long does it take to get a PhD here? 3 years. It's compulsorily 3 years. Not here, I'm talking about the universities. But there, I remember in Columbia University, I used to work in what's called Habermeyer Hall, and there, the normal timing is somewhere between 4.5 to 6 for PhD scholars in chemistry. And then if you look at the other building, Pippin Hall, which is the physics department, and there it's a different question. It's 6.5 to 7 years. A lot of my physics friends were there, so they used to take so much time. So it is not the time that matters, it's what you learn during that time. And that can be done only if you are not feeding them, but you are telling them, you know, how to do research. That's all. That's what you should do. Anyway, we have done. Kopraswamy has done extremely well. Even when I had many students at that time At that time, there was a restriction. 6 is the cutoff. We can't have more than 6 students. And of course, I had also a couple of research associates with me. So with this kind of a grouping, it's possible to tell him to interact with other people. That's more important. Kuppuswamy's main merit is, which I was very happy, he and another scholar by name Dr. Chandramouli, who is now also in the US, and both of them can take care of my job. I will tell them what to do, and they will take care of it. But that's exactly what they did. It's true. When he came here after some time, I had to go on my sabbatical. 7 for the sabbatical. 11 for the sabbatical, 2 people are taking care of, you know, loading it with each other, 3 or 4 of the other people, including those who got already a PhD. So basically, Kuppuswamy is a leader by himself. In fact, he takes over the leadership. He doesn't have to be given. He takes over. And that's how, when he went to NIH first to work with Dr. Rifkin, he's also a good friend of mine, Rifkin, and later with Dr. Swayer, that he took over. In fact, Swayer used to come and tell me, well, he's taking over my job, it's all right, it's okay with me. So he's taking care of himself very well. And that's why they went together to Ohio State University, very occupied, you know, a couple of chair professorship, as well as he was the director of the EPR group. EPR has been his main sustenance, no doubt about it. But at the same time, he has also other facets that he has proved that he's a Tamil, he was trying to become a Tamil scholar also. But more importantly, Kuppuswamy can be given a job which not many people can take over. And that's what I used to do. He used to do second moments calculation. When it becomes a necessity, he does crystallography, all those things. I'll just ask him to go learn and do it, and he will do it. And that's what sustains him now. So it's very easy to become great, provided somebody knows how to make themselves become great. Yeah. I think Kuppuswamy deserves this award. I'm very happy that as one of my excellent students has received this award. Thank you very much.
That time I was married, so when I came here, I was not staying in the hostel. That's when IIT was building the Z-type quarters here for research scholars. So you were the first to move in. So we were there for a couple of years. And then we got promoted to take the faculty's house here. He went on sabbatical. So we moved to Lakeview Road, 15 Lakeview Road, Piri. 15 Lakeview Road. So until he came back and I graduated, so kind of we got promoted to that house from Z type to faculty.
You
don't do
Z type, you can live anywhere.
Right. I remember that. I remember that Z type.
Yes. They were trying to get rid of that.
If, as people have started wandering off, I just want to quickly offer a vote of thanks. Thanks to Dr. Kuppuswamy for making this trip and collecting his award. I want to thank all the committee members. I think I'm the only one left now from the committee, but for doing that job with great diligence and selecting the 10 best candidates out of a very large number. And I want to thank all of you for joining this function. And we hope to see more of you in future. So. In fact, the next time you are here, we'll try to arrange a more general lecture also. Maybe you could talk about some of the things that you just said. You know, I think it would be very good advice for our graduate students also.
Thank you.
Thank you again.